Hey, you guys, just another quickie on the drum machine, okay? So there's three kind of ways that Bitwig gives you drum machines. It gives you the electronic one, it gives you a sample, which is just a recorded bit of audio, and a multi-sampler. So let's start with the electronic one. This is a preset called the Deep Kit, okay? And you can see it's got E-kick, electronic kick. And that's what it sounds like. And essentially, this is just a synthesizer, really. And the way they're making that sound is basically by taking a high pitch and moving it to a low pitch really fast. If it was slowed down, it'd be like, okay, or something like that. And this delineates that motion, okay? So in here, there's a bunch of stuff that you can play with to get the kick sound that you want. First is decay. And so how long does the sound stick around for after you've hit it? If I turn this up, see, it clings on for quite a while. If I turn it down, it's just a kind of a clickier kick, as it were. Okay. Of course, I can tune it. Which is great if you're into trap music. You can click that. And you can click the automation lane, and you can automate the tuning of the kick drum, which is pretty funky. Click is exactly like it sounds. It literally adds a click at the beginning of the kick. Very subtle, but I usually leave it on. It just depends on the music. Tone, you can think of as a low-pass filter. And basically, if I turn this all the way down, it's just taking out a bunch of high frequencies. Listen. Right? Pmod is that amount as far as how high of a note does it start at. Because remember how it's just a tone that goes from high to low really fast? Well, how high do we start? Let's have a listen. So down here, it's starting pretty low. And in this case, it's actually giving a nicer sound. Let me click this guy. If I start up here versus there, you can kind of hear the difference. And this curve is telling us how quickly is it falling down to that lower note. If I bring it all the way up, click it, bring it all the way up. See, it's holding up at the top note a lot longer than that. And the decay is basically roughly the same thing, where it's just holding the top note. See how it actually never makes it down to the bottom when it's all the way open. Whereas if I close it, it's basically only the bottom note. Okay? Velocity sensitive is how sensitive is this note to velocity? Well, I'm playing on my laptop keyboard, so it's just gonna, whatever I set this to is what it's gonna sound like. So this is it at maximum all the time. And if I go like this, it's like bringing the velocity down. Okay. And output is output. No, I don't think you need an explanation on that. All right, let's move over to the sampler. In this instance, you actually have a recorded sample that somebody graciously went and recorded a DW, I think this is a DW, or it could be just whatever, kick drum with a microphone and put it into this sampler, okay? And you can see as a line moves past, it's playing that sample. Now I can grab this and move it further down and start the sample later, but then I miss that nice transient, but maybe there's applications where you might want to do that. And of course, this you can pitch to. To suit the key of your song, which you should do. And this is your ADSR. So basically, the attack is set very low because I want the sound to come in immediately. I want to preserve that beginning bit of sound information. If I turn it up, see it kind of kind of fades into the sound, which for a kick drum may or may not be what you want. Typically not. The decay and the sustain are how long that that sound plays for. So let's turn them down. So you only have the click, which can be super handy if you're layering kicks and you like the click off of this one, but you like the tone off another one. You can turn these two guys down and blend the two, and you'll have a pretty nice sound. Okay, this is the start or the loop length. It's not looping right now, so this is nullified. And this is how far in. This is exactly the same as grabbing that and moving it forward, except it doesn't show it to you. But the reason they put this here is because now you can put like an LFO, or you can put an audio sidechain, whatever you got, and attach it to that, where you can't attach it to this, but it's the same thing. So now you can kind of automate your kick drum. Okay, again, velocity sensitive, your gain and your output. Now you also have the ability to add effects. If you want only your kick drum to have reverb on it, you can put that in here. I've never done that. Maybe I'll experiment with that a little bit more, but that's basically what that is. And this is just the sample that they're using. It's just the file name, basically. Okay, if you want it to key track, which is like anything in Sampler, you click this button, but that doesn't make sense because I want the sample to be played naturally as it was recorded. Yeah, but in other instances, that's useful. Okay, the other way is the multi-sampler. And why this is cool is because when I play on my laptop keyboard, it's just playing that sample. Let's click into it. Click into edit multi-sample. So now if I play on my touch sensitive drum pad, if I touch it lightly, you can see it's playing this sample. If I hit it, it's hitting up here. And so basically what somebody did when they recorded the drum samples is they recorded a sample of the guy playing the kick or girl playing the kick lightly, and then playing it really hard, and they put it up here. And so depending on how hard you hit the drum pad, if it's velocity sensitive, will push you deeper into these different samples. And that's really great because it's not only volume that changes when you hit a kick drum hard, it's like an overall timbre of the kick drum. And so they've kind of figured that out for you and given you four different layers. Okay, and again, let me just exit this. Again, it gives you all the same controls that you had before with the ability to add effects to it. But the only difference is here, these are much more quality samples. Even though you can't see the audio wave, you can still shift the start time and the ADSR and pitch it and everything. But in this instance, if you're going to do stuff that requires velocity sensitive playing, then you get you get the luxury of having four different samples that are actually acoustically recorded being played at four different levels of intensity. Okay, and so that's basically it. If you load up a drum machine, you'll kind of get one of the three of these, either the multi-sampler, the sampler, or the synthesizer, or the e-kick, e-snare, e-hat. And inside here, it could be a combination of all three of them. You might have a multi-sampler for a kick, but an e-snare, and it depends on how you set it up and what you use. But at least this way, when you go to edit something, you'll be able to look at it and you'll understand what's really happening inside. Okay, so just recognize that these are synthesizers, those are single recorded samples, and these are much more luxurious recorded samples because there's four of them. They take four times as long to actually record these samples and put them into the multi-sampler. Okay, I hope that helps you out a little bit. If you have any comments or questions, definitely get in touch with me. Leave it in the comment section. You can email me. You can visit my website. All those links are on the About page. And don't forget to subscribe. All right, talk to you later.